Well, graduates, families, and friends, we are pleased to welcome you to the 49th commencement ceremony of the Lake Campus of Wright State University. Will everyone please stay in your seats or move to them if you haven't taken them yet so that we can get this ceremony underway. So, good evening. I am Dr. Dan Crane. I'm the interim dean and chief administrative officer for the Lake Campus. And I'd like to ask you at this time to please rise for the national anthem. It will be performed for us by Lake Campus professor and pianist, Dr. Dane Daniel. Thank you so much, Dr. Daniel. Everyone, please be seated. In order to have our celebration here in person today, we are asking that all guests and graduates abide by our current state health and safety guidelines. Please practice social distancing and wear a face covering throughout the duration of this event. We do very much appreciate your help and cooperation with that. So that we can honor all of our graduates today, I also ask that you please remain seated and try to stay seated throughout the entire ceremony. Our candidates for graduation will certainly appreciate that courtesy. Well, congratulations, Wright State University Lake Campus Class of 2021, and a very special welcome also to the Class of 2020 graduates who have returned to celebrate with us in person this year. We are so proud of each and every student sitting here today. I'd like to share a few facts about our Lake Campus graduates for 2021. We have 51 associate's degree candidates and 189 bachelor's candidates. 2021, this year, marks the first time the Lake Campus has awarded more than 200 degrees. It's quite an accomplishment. Of our 240 students whose success we're celebrating today, 233 of them are from the great state of Ohio. 5 students come from nearby Indiana, and we also have 1 graduate from Michigan and 1 from as far away as Florida. The average GPA for this year's graduating class is a very impressive 3.36. We're so pleased that a total of 101 students are going to be able to participate in person with us for the 3 sessions of our commencement ceremonies this year. Wright State provides our students with unique opportunities to enhance their learning experiences beyond the classroom. Employers recognize the value of the experiences that you gain when you balance school, work, and extracurricular activities. The Lake Campus would very much like to recognize those great accomplishments. And so, I'd like to ask this, graduates, if you participated during your time with us in a service learning project, competed in an academic collegiate competition, or participated in a faculty student research project, please stand and remain standing. Thank you. Anyone else? There's more. If you're a veteran or a dependent of one who has served, or if you are a student athlete, please stand and be recognized. Thank you. If you were or are a member of a student organization or served as a student employee, had an internship or co-op, worked part or full time during your college career, please stand and be recognized. Isn't that impressive? Ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, a degree from the Lake campus of Wright State University means so much more than just books and lectures and classroom exams. Please join me, ladies and gentlemen, in recognizing the hard work, dedication, and commitment of our graduates from the classes of 2020 and 2021. Graduates, you may now be seated. I'd like to take just a moment at this point to recognize some important guests here for today's commencement celebration. For those who I'll be recognizing, please also stand and remain standing. And ladies and gentlemen, please hold your applause until the end. But first, I'd like to draw your attention and recognize a member of Wright State University's Board of Trustees who's with us today, Mr. William Montgomery. Also, we have a number of members of the Wright State University Lake Campus faculty with us today. Please stand. And we have with us many members of the Wright State Lake Campus staff who have been serving us as volunteers here today. So I see some of you in the back. Everyone, please stand, all the staff. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming our board member, the Lake Campus faculty and staff. Thank you so much for your support of these graduates during their time at the Lake Campus. Well, we're getting to the good parts, folks. It's with great pleasure that I now can present to you the 8th president of Wright State University, Dr. Susan L. Edwards. Since Dr. Edwards became president in 2019, she has focused on recruitment, retention, and relationships. She's personally committed to student success, especially in terms of retention, experiential learning, and high-quality classroom education. Dr. Edwards is committed to fostering a welcome and inclusive campus for students, faculty, and staff. She's taken great care to focus on strengthening relations with the community and being very vocal about telling the Wright State story. She's proud of how Wright State serves its students in the region and is honored and humbled to serve as the university's president and its partners in developing those relationships as well. You know, so although Dr. Edwards is not able to join us in person here today, I'd like to ask you to please turn your attention to the video monitor for a special message for our Lake Campus graduates from President Susan Edwards.
Congratulations, Lakers. Today we celebrate this, your graduation day, and what a truly special celebration it is, because you are here together and in person. I'm sorry that I can't join you for your in-person celebration, but I do want to offer some thoughts and warm wishes for this, your special day. Take a moment, look around you, take it all in. This in-person commencement is proof that we're on the path to a brighter future. It is possible because of the wonders of medical science, because of vaccine developments and supply chain successes, and because of people like you who have followed and continue to follow public health guidelines. Thank you. I urge you to keep us on this path so that Ohio and the US can get back on track. We've come so far together, but I am counting on you to go further. You, your parents, loved ones, your friends, your Wright State faculty and staff who have helped and supported you, they are all here in this moment together. Savor it. This is your reward for all of your hard work. We could not be happier for you. But more rewarding to us is that you have made it here, to the finish line, having earned your college degree. We couldn't be more proud of each and every one of you. How fitting is it that our first in-person commencement comes in the spring? This is, after all, a season of great renewal. It is a time of new growth and rebirth. The world has changed since you started your educational journey here at Wright State's Lake Campus. It has been a time of great challenge and opportunity. Because you are here today, I know that you have met those challenges. You have seized those opportunities. How did you do it? What traits did you acquire that will serve you well as you follow your path from today into your future? Adaptability, persistence, resilience. You have used these and others to overcome obstacles in front of you and succeed in ways that you might never have dreamed you ever would. But you have also honed a few new skills that I have a sense will be of great value to you also. You've acquired invaluable technical skills that have helped you in many respects get the job done, but have also helped you stay connected and close with others when we've had to be apart. You've embraced emotional skills that have helped you cope with the challenges in front of you. They've helped you with the uncertainty of what to expect and helped you conjure the empathy critical to supporting and caring for others. All the while, you have demonstrated the resiliency, tenacity, and sheer grit that Wright State Lakers are made of. You have been amazing. Did you know that yours is the largest graduating class in Lake campus history invited to participate in commencement? Today, 242 Lake campus students are earning either an associate's or bachelor's degree. You are part of a trend here at the Lake campus, which across the last 10 years is second to none in terms of enrollment growth. Enrollment has increased at the Lake campus by a larger percentage than at any of Ohio's 23 other regional campuses. What can this success be attributed to? Well, your hard work, of course, but there are larger reasons also. The Lake campus carefully assessed the wants and needs of the community in the Western Central Ohio and has developed and offered in-demand programs such as nursing, education, and engineering. The support students receive from the Western Ohio Educational Foundation, which continues its exclusive support of students through scholarship funds, is immensely beneficial to Lake campus students. Because of its status as a regional campus, the Lake campus enables Wright State to award associate degrees and has allowed the university to be a leader among four-year universities in Ohio in helping upskill employees with both for-credit and not-for-credit offerings through the state's Tech Cred program. I think of your broad diversity of backgrounds and support mechanisms, your collective assemblage of experiences and choices that have brought you here, and it brings me sheer joy. Because there is no one path, there is no one answer for how to get here today to graduation day. I want you to be aware and fully empowered right now and hear me. Each of you is writing your own story. And each of those stories are special. Whether you realize it or not, they will become family stories that you, your parents, and perhaps even your children will tell. Your story of how you got here today is not just about you, it is you. All of you here today, you are the proof that education is for everyone. So what will you do now? Where will you take your story next? You've just written one of the most important chapters of your life because of what it unlocks for your future. We may say to ourselves, wow, look what we managed to get through. Look how far we've come. Look at what we can just prove that we have just done. Spend a few moments today and do that. But I'd caution you with a simple bit of advice that served me well through the years. It's one that I have come to appreciate even more these days. Don't look back. You are not going that way. Today, this graduation day, at this in-person commencement, you have set your path forward by graduating. It is this path forward that presents you with endless possibilities. So set your sights on the future. Visualize where you are going, realize your dreams, and show the world what Wright State Lakers are made of. I am so proud of your strength and perseverance. Graduates, it's my great honour to welcome you to the Wright State alumni. You join a family of more than 115,000 strong who are making a difference throughout the country, all over Ohio and across the nation and even more across the world. As I bring my comments to a close, I want to convey my sincerest gratitude to Lake Campus faculty and staff for the resilience you have also demonstrated on behalf of your students and their families. Thank you for continuing to keep our students the focus of why we choose to work in higher education. Today is the culmination of that work, where we come together as a community to celebrate the achievements of our students. It is the most important day on Wright State's calendar. Graduates, I cannot wait to see all that you will achieve in your lives and how you will make your mark on the world. Congratulations to you all. You are truly awesome, and my charge to you is to go forth and be brilliant. Thank you.
Well, thank you to Dr. Edwards. That was beautiful, and we certainly look forward to a time when she can join us again in person. I'm very pleased to announce that we will now begin the conferral of degrees. Will the candidates for bachelor's degrees please rise? Trustee Montgomery, I have the honor of presenting these candidates who have completed all requirements for bachelor's degrees.
Upon the recommendation of the faculty, and by authority of the Board of Trustees, I hereby confer upon you the appropriate degrees with all the rights and privileges thereto appertaining.
Hello. I'm Dr. Giovanna Folo, president of the Lake Campus Faculty Senate. Graduates, please stand as your name is called and remain standing as we announce your degree and honors when applicable. Please be seated after your recognition so the next graduate may stand. In addition to those present today, we will be announcing all of the graduate names in your majors for those joining us remotely via our live stream. I would assume we sit down at this moment. It's new for all of us. Bradley J. Axe, Integrated Science Studies. Adam J. Bornhurst, Integrated Science Studies. Chasselin T. Cobb, Integrated Science Studies, magna cum laude. Benjamin A. Homan, Integrated Science Studies. Brittany R. Kenny, Integrated Science Studies, public health minor, magna cum laude. Bethany S. Schimp, Integrated Science Studies, business minor, cum laude. Benjamin N. Strang, Integrated Science Studies. Skylar B. Ward, Integrated Science Studies. Cody W. Wendell, Integrated Science Studies. Zion I. Armstrong, Electrical Engineering. Sean M. Besiker, Electrical Engineering. Janice M. Drayrump, Electrical Engineering, summa cum laude. Adam Guggenbiller, Electrical Engineering. Tristan F. Moore, Electrical Engineering, Business Minor, Magna Cum Laude. Aaron M. Nykamp, Electrical Engineering and Mechanical Engineering, Summa Cum Laude. Ethan E. Rhodes, Electrical Engineering. Bailey S. Wenning, Electrical Engineering, Business Minor. Ryan T. Anderson, Mechanical Engineering. Braden A. Baker, Mechanical Engineering. Alex T. Bergman, Mechanical Engineering. Jared L. Bettinger, Mechanical Engineering, Business Minor. Brittany A. Brookhart, Mechanical Engineering. Dustin R. Brunswick, Mechanical Engineering. Dane A. Froning, Mechanical Engineering. Gavin R. Hawk, Mechanical Engineering. Angela B. Heitkamp, Mechanical Engineering, Magna Cum Laude. Jonathan H. Heitkamp, Mechanical Engineering, Cum Laude. Kyle Heitkamp, Mechanical Engineering. Shane A. Hemelarg, Mechanical Engineering. Brittany R. Heestand, Mechanical Engineering, Summa Cum Laude. Dylan P. Keller, Mechanical Engineering. Jeremy T. Kemen, Mechanical Engineering. Ryan M. Kemper, Mechanical Engineering, Cum Laude. Aaron K. Kitzmiller, Mechanical Engineering. Jonathan P. Knapschaefer, Mechanical Engineering, Business Minor, Summa Cum Laude. Josiah D. Kramer, Mechanical Engineering. Dylan J. Kuhl, Mechanical Engineering. Matthew A. Keeter, Mechanical Engineering. Logan P. Martin, Mechanical Engineering, Business Minor. Alex C. Mullenkamp, Mechanical Engineering, Cum Laude. Kirsten R. Neumeier, Mechanical Engineering, Magna Cum Laude. Lucas J. Sheriff, Mechanical Engineering. Chad W. Stamen, Mechanical Engineering, Cum Laude. Cole J. Sogler, Mechanical Engineering. Blake A. Stevens, Mechanical Engineering. Nicole M. Fote, Mechanical Engineering, Summa Cum Laude. Michaela L. Ashbaugh, Technical and Applied Studies in Agriculture, Business Minor, Magna Cum Laude. Jocelyn B. Mert, Technical and Applied Studies in Agriculture, Cum Laude. Kyle B. Fullenkamp, Technical and Applied Studies in Agriculture. Kyle E. Moore, Technical and Applied Studies in Agriculture. Olivia R. McDade, Technical and Applied Studies in Agriculture. Jared E. Meeks, Technical and Applied Studies in Agriculture, Business Minor. Anthony J. Osterholt, Technical and Applied Studies in Agriculture. Charles V. Painter, Technical and Applied Studies in Agriculture, Business Minor, Magna Cum Laude. Larkin J. Ressler, Technical and Applied Studies in Agriculture. Brooke E. Schnelker, Technical and Applied Studies in Agriculture. Parker C. Selcott, Technical and Applied Studies in Agriculture, Cum Laude. Bailey A. Brown, Technical and Applied Studies in Graphic Design. Jonathan T. Clow, Technical and Applied Studies in Graphic Design. Natalie S. Frank, Technical and Applied Studies in Graphic Design. Paisley M. Jones, Technical and Applied Studies in Graphic Design, Summa Cum Laude. Anna C. Kleinhans, Technical and Applied Studies in Graphic Design, summa cum laude. Andrew J. Klepatz, Technical and Applied Studies in Graphic Design, cum laude. Nicole A. LeBrun, Technical and Applied Studies in Graphic Design. Rachel A. Reichert, Technical and Applied Studies in Graphic Design, cum laude. Savannah J. Wygant, Technical and Applied Studies in Graphic Design, cum laude. Courtney J. Davis, Technical and Applied Studies in Multimedia Design, magna cum laude. Ashley Lehman, Technical and Applied Studies in Multiple Media Design. Samuel J. Birch, Technical and Applied Studies in Graphic Design and Multimedia Design, cum laude. Andrea L. Fromelli, Technical and Applied Studies in Graphic Design and Multimedia Design. Kristen M. Heal, Technical and Applied Studies in Graphic Design and Multimedia Design, magna cum laude. Michaela N. Hennigar, Technical and Applied Studies in Graphic Design and Multimedia Design, magna cum laude. Shannon J. McCabe, Technical and Applied Studies in Graphic Design and Multimedia Design, summa cum laude. Tyler M. Rice, Technical and Applied Studies in Graphic Design and Multimedia Design, magna cum laude. Christopher Smith, Technical and Applied Studies in Graphic Design and Multimedia Design. Edwin K. Rayer, Technical and Applied Studies in Supervision and Management. Greta R. Reed, Technical and Applied Studies in Agriculture.
Congratulations, everyone. At this time, I'd like to ask the candidates for associate's degrees to please rise. Trustee Montgomery, I have the honor of presenting these candidates who have been recommended by the faculty, having completed all requirements for associate's degrees.
Upon the recommendation of the faculty and by authority of the Board of Trustees, I hereby confer upon you the appropriate degrees with all the rights and privileges thereto appertaining.
Graduates, please stand as your name is called and remain standing as we announce your degree and honors when applicable. Please be seated after your recognition so the next graduate may stand. In addition to those present today, we will be announcing all of the graduate names in your majors for those joining us remotely via our live stream. Colleen Sharpen, Communication Studies. Emma L. Bretz, Liberal Studies. Benjamin H. Safford, Liberal Studies. Tori A. Bratcher, Psychology. Judith A. Kroll, Psychology Honors. Daniel Mogilevsky, Psychology Highest Honors. Rebecca N. Iink, Social Work. Jordan R. Farley, Sociology. Margaret V. Patterson, Biological Sciences. Marie N. Zeringer, Biological Sciences. Christy Eilig, Business and Administration. Mitchell L. Apple, Business and Administration, Honors. Jacob Cockerell, Business and Administration. Evan J. Diller, Business and Administration. Kayla M. Edwards, Business and Administration. Dalen Froning, Business and Administration, Honors. Kendra L. Godsey, Business and Administration, High Honors. Allison M. Heitkamp, Business and Administration. Ariana N. Jones, Business and Administration. Allison L. Katterheirich, Business and Administration. Caleb Post, Business and Administration. Matthew Riddler, Business and Administration, Highest Honors. Hannah Snyder, Business and Administration. Colin P. Vandiver, Business and Administration. Kimberly Winner, Business and Administration. Michael Zimes, Business and Administration, Honors. Tyler Clint, Chemistry, Highest Honors. Samuel L. Conklin, Earth Environmental Sciences, Highest Honors. Allison Gear, Applied Business Technologies. Megan A. Holthaus, Applied Business Technologies. Riley L. Schmidt, Applied Business Technologies, Highest Honors. Victoria R. Umstead, Applied Business Technologies, High Honors. Andrew C. Gray, Graphic and Multimedia Design. Taylor A. Kaufman, Graphic and Multimedia Design, High Honors. Nicholas R. Lunicky, Graphic and Multimedia Design. Trevor Dotson, Technical Study. Jeffrey J. Hendrickson, Technical Study. Sarah F. Kramer, Technical Study. David A. Wren, Technical Study. Virginia Beckman, Technical Study in Agriculture, Honors. Kenzie Kaiser, Technical Study in Agriculture, Highest Honors. Courtney Metzger, Technical Study in Agriculture, Highest Honors. Sarah E. Schatt, Technical Study in Agriculture. Emily Schroeder, Technical Study in Agriculture, Honors. Dustin K. Wilcox, Technical Study in Law Enforcement. Dylan Bush, Technical Study in Law Enforcement Academy. John Hain, Technical Study in Law Enforcement Academy, Highest Honors. Mark K. Murr, Technical Study in Law Enforcement Academy. Noah Nyport, Technical Study in Law Enforcement Academy, High Honors. Derek Seifring, Technical Study in Law Enforcement Academy, High Honors. Ryan J. Spatz, Technical Study in Skill Track. I congratulate the Wright State University Lake Campus classes of 2020 and 2021. We are very pleased that you have chosen to attend the Lake Campus of Wright State University for your alma mater. Graduates, please rise once more. This is the best part. As a long-standing tradition, please move your tassel from right to left to signify your achievement. Congratulations. Please be seated. I am pleased to share that Governor Mike DeWine has recorded a special message for our graduates. Please turn to the video monitor for his remarks.
Hello, I'm Ohio Governor Mike DeWine. Congratulations to the Wright State University class of 2021. You made it. Graduating from college is a big accomplishment at any time, but graduating from college during a once-in-a-hundred-years pandemic requires an extra measure of fortitude. You have been tested, and you have shown great resilience. Theodore Roosevelt said, "Believe you can, and you're halfway there." Well, you believed you could. You made it past the halfway point and kept on going all the way to the finish line. Now, today, you're receiving your diploma. You did the hard work, and I hope you're very proud of all that you have done. As you celebrate, remember to thank those who helped you get here. Your professors, your coaches, your academic advisors, fellow students, friends, and of course, your parents, grandparents, other family members. They helped you, they guided you, celebrated your major wins, listened when you hit some snags, and perhaps gave you a push when you needed one. The important thing is, you never quit. Some of you may have gotten sidetracked or taken longer paths, but you persevered, you made it. I have tremendous faith in the class of 21 because going through a major challenge such as COVID-19 can be powerfully transformative. Tough times make us stronger. Today, you're ready to go out in the world at a time when COVID-19 vaccinations are ushering in the recovery stage in Ohio. Growth and greater prosperity are ahead. I'm optimistic about Ohio's future, and I'm optimistic about your future in Ohio. As you consider your next steps, I hope you use the great opportunities here in the Buckeye State. I encourage you to keep growing your skills and talents here. Ohio is a wonderful place to build your dream, launch a successful career, raise a family, create a beautiful home. Whatever is next for you, please know that I'll be cheering you on, and many other people will be as well. You'll always be part of the Ohio family. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Good evening, graduates, family and friends, and distinguished guests. My name is Carla Hirschfeld, and as president of the Lake Campus Alumni Network, it is an honor to be able to speak to you today. On behalf of the Wright State University Alumni Association Board of Directors, thank you for allowing me to introduce you to the Alumni Association. Founded in 1971, it is the Alumni Association's mission to engage alumni in supporting the university. We provide opportunities, activities, and ongoing resources to our alumni by offering a sense of belonging, community, connection, and pride. Graduates, you are now a member of Wright State Alumni Association. Along with more than 100,000 graduates who have come before you, you are welcomed into a caring and supportive community, and we encourage you to stay connected to your alma mater and fellow alumni through our many opportunities for networking, service, and philanthropy. Graduation is a day of celebration, but it's also a day to reflect on what it took to get here. All of your hard work is being rewarded. Also remember your support system of family and friends, and the people you have met on your journey, including the faculty and staff of Wright State who've helped you cross the finish line. Please take a moment to reflect and thank those who made the journey a little easier. My words of wisdom to you are that your education and the time that it has taken you to receive your degree are never wasted. It's yours. Use it to create your own story. Moving on from today, we hope that you will do well, but we also hope that you will do good, continuing in the Wright State tradition of changing lives. And lastly, I have the honor of being one of the first people to say, congratulations, graduates.
Thank you to our governor and to Ms. Hirschfeld for sharing their messages, even though they aren't able to be here in person with us to celebrate today. Ladies and gentlemen, it's been our honor to have so many parents, family, friends, and guests join us in person here tonight. Before closing, I want to thank those who helped make this ceremony a really wonderful celebration in these difficult times. First, Dr. Dane Daniel, our musical performer, and Sarah Shepherd, our ASL interpreter. You know, I have to say that I'm also deeply grateful to the Lake Campus Commencement Committee, our staff volunteers, for their excellent service once again this year in helping us put on this celebration. I also want to take a moment to thank Professor Giovanna Folo for serving as our orator for this commencement ceremony. And I have to let you know that your willingness to serve and read all those names is very, very much appreciated. Please join me in giving all of those individuals an appreciation of your thanks as well. Finally, to those of you who are joining us remotely today, including our graduates, faculty, staff, and members of the Western Ohio Educational Foundation, family, friends, and all the others who supported our graduates during their time with us at the Lake Campus, congratulations and thank you. We appreciate your understanding of the unique challenges we faced in hosting this ceremony in person this year. All right, well, we're proud that so many Wright State University graduates remain in the area. Graduates, wherever your career may take you, we do sincerely hope you stay close to your alma mater, Wright State, and especially to our Lake Campus. Now, I saved a truly special recognition for this moment close to the end. No one, graduates, arrives at where you are today alone. You've been encouraged and supported by many of the people who we have the pleasure of having with us here today. To allow you to honor them, I'd like to ask the following groups to stand, if you're able, and to remain standing. Family members and guests of graduates, please stand. Wright State University board members, faculty, staff, and all other university affiliates, please stand. All others with a special relationship to a graduate and those who are cheering for our graduates' success, please stand and remain standing. Graduates of the class of 2020 and 2021, these are the people who have had a hand in your success. Please rise yourselves and show them your appreciation for their support. Graduates, please remain standing. This does conclude the 49th commencement of the Lake Campus of Wright State University. Thank you all so much. In order to ensure a safe and healthy exit, we ask that you exit at the door that is closest to you and reunite with your party outside of the building. Thank you so much for your cooperation and understanding here this evening. Congratulations once more, and have a wonderful evening. Thank you, everyone.